This is the Fractal Lumen S36 RGB V2, and it's a small form factor PC builder's dream. It's inexpensive, it has a super stealthy and pretty RGB pump head, and a low profile design to help it fit in those tighter spaces. But it feels locked in time. We're gonna talk about all that and more right here, right now on Robeytech. If you know Fractal, they are constantly testing the boundaries of design, looking for ways to keep their product functional while simultaneously holding fast to their design language. Enter the Fractal Lumen V2, an AIO design with a lot of the hallmarks we like to see for small form factor builds. Things like flexible hosing, a low profile CPU block, and a pump located outside of the CPU block. This makes sense when you consider that Fractal has some beautiful SFF cases that would benefit from an AIO like this. Now, according to Fractal, their aim with the Lumen was to give both seasoned and beginner builders an AIO option that is both cost conscious and capable of keeping up with modern CPUs. Thanks to Fractal, we get the opportunity to shine a light on the Lumen to see if it can achieve those goals or if the Lumen S36 V2 leaves us in the dark. There's a lot to talk about here, so let's dive in. Starting with the price, the Lumen S36 V2 ARGB retails for around $130. Now, if 360mm version isn't your jam or you need something to fit in a smaller PC case, Fractal also offers the 240mm Lumen S24 V2 and the 280mm S28 V2 in both RGB and non-RGB versions. Since we have the Lumen S36 V2 ARGB, we'll be comparing it against other 360mm AIOs. And for the ease of listening, we'll be referring to it as the Lumen throughout the rest of the video. And when we compare this price to other AIOs like it, the Lumen has competition with other budget-conscious AIOs like the Arctic Liquid Freezer 3 Black and the Fantex Glacier 1 M25 Gen 2. Now, the big question that we'll have to answer here is whether or not it can match or beat the thermal performance of either, or at least be easier to install than the Liquid Freezer. Now, moving on to compatibility, the Lumen has support for a wide range of CPUs. On the Intel side, the Lumen supports CPU spans from modern Intel Core Ultra 200S series CPUs all the way back to the original Core i7. As for AMD, the Lumen supports modern AMD CPUs on both AM4 and AM5 sockets, as well as CPUs dating all the way back to 2006. So for all of you AM2 users still rocking DDR2 memory, Fractal has an AIO for you. Basically, whether you're on Intel or AMD, the Lumen will pretty much work for any mainstream CPU. And if you're trying to keep a nostalgic build cool, it will work here too. Unfortunately, when it comes to installation hardware, Fractal's kept the nostalgia goggles on for the mounting mechanisms of yesteryears. While the actual brackets are easy enough to slide out and replace for AMD or Intel builds, mounting the CPU block onto the CPU is far less so. For AMD, the Lumen makes use of the stock AMD motherboard brackets by clipping onto them, which is fine if you have a few sets of tiny hands helping you. This bracket also gets in the way of the RGB cable. We had to bend it in what felt like a super unnatural way in order to get it in place. Unfortunately, the process with Intel wasn't a whole lot easier. While we're used to installing AIOs, basically installing thousands of them, the brackets Fractal chose for the Lumen require an additional set of hands. The plastic spacers don't quite hold the mounting brackets in place on their own. It's like you need someone holding it in place while the other is securing the CPU block in place. For Intel installation, we recommend installing this AIO before putting your motherboard inside your PC case. We also recommend liking, subscribing, and ringing those notification bells here at Robeytech and Robeytech Live. And you know what? None of those require any plastic spacers. Now, since we're in the neighborhood, let's talk about the pump. Now, we alluded to this earlier, but the actual pump for the Lumen is not on the CPU pump. It's located inside the actual radiator. This pump has an operating range of up to 4,000 RPM, which on paper beats the pump speed of your Fantex Glacier 1 M25 Gen 2, which, by the way, you can watch a review of right here. Since the pump is located inside the radiator, this allows the CPU block to be much smaller, which, again, it's great if you're trying to use the AIO inside of a smaller case. As for the radiator, it has a standard thickness of 27mm. This matches with AIOs like the Glacier 1 M25, the NZXT Kraken, and the Corsair IQ Link H150i. As for fans, the Lumen is equipped with 3 Fractal Aspect 12 RGB PWM fans. These fans have a maximum airflow rating of up to 56 CFM with a static pressure rating of up to 2.34 mm H2O. On paper, they're not the most powerful or performant fans we've seen paired with an AIO, but we've also seen worse. We'll just have to see how they do in the testing. Oh, and be prepared to do some extra cable management here, as these RGB fans have 2 cables, one for RGB and one for the fan itself. As for RGB control, the Lumen uses a 5-volt RGB header that connects directly to your motherboard. That means you can use your motherboard's RGB control software to modify the lighting for the Lumen. Interestingly, Fractal also lists support for Razer Chroma software as well, so great news for all you Razer fans. Not a whole lot of extra to add here. In this case, simple is good. With all this in mind, let's look at the data. As we get into our testing, just a reminder that all of our AIO tests are performed in nearly identical Intel and AMD rigs. Notes on the screen for details. All of this is done under the same conditions to keep the data as clean as absolutely possible. Now we're gonna go through this pretty quickly, so feel free at any point to pause the video if you wanna make some notes. As a reminder, we're still rebuilding our AMD test data, so please be patient with us as we add AIOs along the way. Okay, let's get into the data, starting with our Intel bench. Starting at CPU idle, the Lumen held thermal averages in the mid 28 degrees Celsius range. This puts it in line with AIOs like the Corsair Titan RX and the H150i. This is on the warmer side of our charts, but we're just getting started. Moving on to CPU load, we saw temperature averages just over 83 degrees Celsius. This put the Lumen in line with AIOs like the ASUS ProArt LC and the Arctic Liquid Freezer 3 Black. Again, the Lumen is trending warmer, but this is a pretty brutal test. Looking at the average wattage here, the Fractal Lumen looks like it wants to compete with an average of around 235.4 watts. This puts the Lumen close to the ASUS Ryugen 3 and the HydraShift 360S. So how did that translate into our Cinebench scores? Well, if you look at this chart, a number of our tested AIOs were landing within a super tight margin here. While the Lumen does land in the bottom half of our rankings, it's within 250 points of the Ryugen, which is not a bad bar to aim for. Now moving on to our gaming benchmarks, the Lumen landed at just over 51 degrees average, which is again on the warmer side of our charts with AIOs like the Titan RX, the Lee & Lee HydraShift R, and the Fantex Glacier 1D30. From a power draw standpoint, the Lumen averaged around 96.4 watts, which was right on the heels of the NZXT Kraken Elite. Now let's talk about the AMD side. The Lumen stayed squarely in the middle with our test of the 7700X. With an average temperature just under 38 degrees Celsius, the Lumen snuggled up between the new Glacier 1 M25 and the Titan RX. However, under CPU load, the picture is not as cozy for the Lumen. With an average of just under 89 degrees Celsius, the Lumen was the warmest AIO in our AMD CPU load test charts by over 1 degree Celsius. As for power draw under load, all of our AMD tested AIOs ran between 144 and 145 watts, so much like we've seen in the past, there isn't a whole lot of diversity here. Now the Lumen's average was the second highest here with an average of over 144 watts. Again, our AMD Cinebench scores are clustered a bit tighter than our Intel ones, however the Lumen managed to land the second highest score under load on the AMD side. In our 1440p gaming benchmarks, the Lumen remained on the warmer side of the AMD charts with an average of over 53 degrees Celsius. It did manage to hold average temperatures a whole degree cooler than the new Glacier 1, so it didn't do too poorly here. As for power draw, the Lumen averaged just under 77 watts while gaming. This put the Lumen right in between the ProArt LC and the Glacier 1 M25 Gen 2. One other data point worth mentioning, and some of you have asked, a lot of you have asked about this, is how loud is this AIO? Now, to be clear, remember, this is not gonna be the loudest component in your build. More than likely, your fans are going to be, but you guys have asked for it, so we're gonna give it to you. Now, we are gonna be building comparative data here, so this'll look a little bit like it's in isolation, but hang in there, we'll share comparisons once we have more data. As for noise levels, we recorded the Lumen S36 V2 at around 49.4 decibels, with the fans running at what would be gaming temps, and around 60.5 decibels when running at 100% under load. Overall, that's not too terribly loud. You're looking at the noise range that compares to a quiet office environment and the volume of a normal conversation. So with the performance on both Intel and AMD falling in the middle of the pack, what about the value? Well, let's look at the relative value proposition to find out, which we'll put the fancy math up on the screen here. This gives us a dollars per degree of cooling value that we can score and compare, with the lower numbers being better. With a relative value score of 10, the Lumen doesn't quite break into the value leader territory with the Glacier 1 M25 and the Arctic Liquid Freezer 3, but it's also not too far off. This is another situation where you have to decide value for yourself outside of our fancy math. So with all that in mind, would we recommend the Fractal Lumen S36 V2 as your next AIO? Well, our answer is a bit conflicted. So if you've never installed an AIO before, this one is going to be a challenge. So it's not very beginner friendly. While this isn't the only AIO to use this mounting design, it's a tire design that we're really eager to move away from, especially for the sake of beginner builders. The Intel backplate bracket with the plastic washers and spacers is an extremely difficult system for one person to install. Nothing is held in place until you can actually start threading the thumb screws. On the AMD side, trying to line up those clips just right and then make sure you're actually tightening them in the right direction can be anxiety inducing. Not only that, using these mounting hooks gets in the way of the ARGB cable. I know I sound like a grumpy old man here, but I've installed enough AIOs that have moved away from these designs, and it's made me realize how non-user friendly these older methods are. It's just disappointing to see them here. And by the way, we're not just picking on the Lumen here. We had the exact same feelings about the Arctic Liquid Freezer 3, which you could watch our review of right here. With how expensive these AIOs are, they can become a trap to first-time builders looking to maximize their budget. Now, let's talk about fans. On paper, the specs for these included fans are not great, but the thing that left us disappointed was the number of cables we needed to wrangle for RGB and fan control. Listen, I'm fully aware of how much we've been spoiled in an age of unified fan systems and easier mounting solutions. But when we add up things like difficulty of installation and extra cable management, these things make it really hard for us to steer beginner builders towards AIOs like these. This AIO, it just feels time locked. And if you're thinking these moves were to save money, the Fantex Glacier 1 M25 V2 has unified fans, a far better mounting system, and a better price. So it's hard to make an argument here. As for the thermal performance, what we saw was middling, but the temperatures were right within normal operating range. Nothing was in danger during our test, and at no point were we concerned about recommending it based on thermals alone. Could the Lumen perform better with better fans? That's entirely possible. That being said, understanding out of the box that this is not an AIO for hotter running CPUs like 14th gen Core i9s or 7000 series Ryzen 9 CPUs. However, if you're trying to cool a non-K or non-X variant or even a mid-range or maybe even the Core Ultra or 9000 series CPUs, that's a very different story. Though, maybe not with the 240mm version inside of the Fractal Era 2. When we tried to use the 240mm Lumen inside of the Fractal Era 2 to cool a 9800X3D, it was not great. We had to go into the BIOS and had to step Precision Boost Overdrive down to keep our CPU from throttling. But if you want to see the installation process and watch this problem solve, you can check out the live stream about the Fractal Era right here. I know this is a lot of critical feedback, but there is one more thing. As we were filming, we discovered a potential design flaw. There is a high probability that if you unplug the RGB cable on the pump head, that you will remove the entire receiver interface like we did. And it wasn't a thing where we pulled on it wrong or manhandled it. The receiver seemed like it was loosely positioned over the pins, but wasn't secured down in any way. So if you try to plug it back in after removing the cable, you're likely to bend the pins. Basically, this means you can never disassemble completely this AIO without damaging the receiver, unless you want to perform open heart surgery to fix it. We've reached out to Fractal with this concern, and this issue seems to be isolated to our experience in a very small subset of customers. That being said, this just may be one of those situations where most people aren't going to be impacted. However, if you need to replace your thermal paste or move it to another build, just don't disconnect the cable and you should absolutely be fine. Now, all of this sounds super grim for the Lumen, but more than one thing can be true at the same time. And we meant what we said at the beginning about the Lumen ticking a number of boxes for SFF builds. With its low profile CPU block, flexible hosing, and pump that doesn't take up extra space inside of the build, this could be a more effective solution than an air cooler in situations where space is at a premium. That being said, in order for the Lumen to be successful, it needs to be an SFF case or any PC case for that matter that will feed plenty of air into the Lumen's fan. So cases like the Lianli Dan A3 Micro ATX will work. So where does that leave us then? The bottom line is that the Lumen isn't a terrible AIO. It just needs the right conditions to be successful in, and it's not the AIO for absolutely everyone. Is the Lumen good for beginner builders? Not if they really want to enjoy their first PC building experience. Did the Lumen do its job of cooling our test CPU? Yes. Did it cool as well as other AIOs in its price bracket? Sort of. That all depends on the test, the platform, and the AIOs you're comparing it against. Do we still think that there's places where it can shine? Absolutely. Can you see now why we're conflicted about this AIO? With all that in mind, we like the overall aesthetic, the application of RGB, integration into the user's existing motherboard ecosystem, and its potential for smaller builds. Not only that, the Lumen's price is also reasonable, especially when you start looking at non-RGB and smaller options. So our recommendation comes with some strong caveats. If you're looking for a cheap and easy AIO, you may want to look elsewhere. However, if you love the look of the Lumen, and it does look really good, and you don't mind working with things like trickier mounting brackets, experimenting with different fans, using an airflow case, or using a CPU that doesn't require as much cooling, the Fractal Lumen V2 could be a compelling choice for you. But like all tech, the question of worth comes back to you. Would this AIO fill your needs? Only you can decide. But whatever you do, don't unplug the RGB cable unless you're good with tweezers. And that wraps up our thoughts of the Fractal Lumen S36 V2. But we want to know what you think. What do you think about the CPU block's low profile design? And does the Lumen V2 tick the same boxes for SFF builds for you as it does for us? Let us know all that in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, make sure you slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so that way you don't miss notifications on videos like this. We post them on Robeytech or over at Robeytech Live. And if you want to continue the conversation, maybe see what AIO might be best for you, head over to our Discord server, discord.gg/Robeytech. Amazing place to meet other tech and PC enthusiasts who'd love to continue this conversation. And you know what? You might just make a friend. Also, follow us on all the other socials at Robeytech, absolutely everywhere. You guys, thank you so much for watching this video. We look forward to seeing you on the next one.